Tonight, we are going to take a closer look at the Trump administration's decision yesterday to end medical research by government scientists who use human fetal tissue. It's hailed by the pro-life movement and for promoting the dignity of life. Joining us now, Lewis Brown, a former official at the Department of Health and Human Services. He's also the executive director of the Christ Medicus Foundation, a Catholic healthcare group offering Christians an alternative to traditional healthcare. Welcome back to our show.
Thanks for having me back.
This puts the president and the HHS at odds with NIH, the National Institutes of Health, which says that there is very strong evidence that fetal tissue research has scientific benefits. So is it an effective avenue for effective gains?
The one publication I've looked at that had spoken on this one organization has said that those scientific benefits are very limited. Even if so, I think the next question is, at what cost? I think there's wide agreement that this is a grave violation of bioethics, a grave violation of human rights. Even if there was some scientific benefit, it's just not worth it, given we're talking about the body parts of children.
Right. When you were at HHS, was there a political battle internally over this?
Right. I couldn't speak to that, but I can say if you look at what the secretary, what the president, even the prior secretary said from the beginning, and even in HHS public documents, it would continuously talk about the importance of protecting life from conception and natural death, language we'd never heard from the federal government.
Do you talk about, was there talk about alternative methods that are just as effective?
I think there are alternative methods that are just as effective, especially if you look at the results of adult stem cell research. It doesn't go along with a lot of the sociology that's coming out of some of the corners of society today about scientific research, but the results of adult stem cell research has been enormous, and it's something that we should continue to look into.
Now, the university research projects that are underway right now will be allowed to continue. However, when there's a need for funding, it's going to come before an ethics advisory board. Will this lead to more of a marketplace for private funding, however?
Right. I think that remains to be seen. Generally, however, when the federal government says we're no longer going to do this research, conduct this research ourselves, it has a massive impact on the healthcare industry and on private institutions. It remains to be seen, but I think and I hope this will have a chilling effect. That's something that it should have, given the material we're talking about.
What kind of energy does this new policy bring to the pro-life movement, do you think?
Sure. I think it's another good win. It's another reality that the federal government's saying, hey, look, we understand that we should protect human and civil rights from conception to natural death. And we understand that the bioethical cost of doing this kind of research, and we're going to continue to look at that step by step by step. And that's a good thing.
Thank you so much, Lewis Brown, a former official at the Department of Health and Human Services, Executive Director of Christ Medicus Foundation. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.